To disassemble and reassemble a Nokia X7, you will need a small Phillips screwdriver, a pair of pliers, small bladed screwdriver, a T5 Torx star type screwdriver, a pair of tweezers, and a plastic separation tool of some kind. So the first thing we do is to remove the plastic covers on the top of the phone. So from the screen side, just insert your tool here and just lever these little plastic covers up and away from the phone, and it's just held on with double-sided sticky tape. There's no clips here at all. And the same again here on the screen side, just lever in and just gradually lift that away, and just lift it away until it comes unstuck. And again, there's no clips holding that on. Now we can get to these two screws. So using your T5 screwdriver, just undo these. And now we can lift the top off the phone. The top contains the Wi-Fi antenna, so if you find there's damage to this, it might affect your reception. Now we can undo these two T5 screws. And they're all the same size, so don't worry about getting them mixed up. Now we need to remove these silver pins. So using your pliers, just get hold of that pin and just pull it out nice and gently and put that aside and turn it over. And the same again here, just get hold of that pin and just pull it out and put that aside. They're both the same length. Now we need to unplug this ribbon cable, so just lever that up and unplug that and make it stand straight up. Like that. Now come to the bottom of the phone, and we need to remove this plastic cover. So again, from the screen side, just lever in here and lever the bottom up, and it'll gradually come unstuck. Just peel it away. There's no clips on there either. Now we can get to these two back screws at the bottom. So using your T5 screwdriver again, undo these. Well, these are quite a bit different from the others, so you can't get them mixed up. See, it's got a little plain shaft on there. And now we need to remove the touchscreen. So pull the touchscreen away from the top of the phone here, but don't pull too hard, because this ribbon cable won't fit through that gap. So once you've got that, just gradually lever the screen away from the phone. So that side's done. And the same again this side. Just make sure it's fully released. And we can't pull that out because of the ribbon cable. At the bottom here, there's two small clips. There's one just there and just there. You push that in, it releases the touchscreen completely, and that's now free, and you can lift it up and away from the body. Now we need to remove the LCD screen. Now it's stuck on with double-sided sticky tape, and it's really well stuck on there, and you need to be careful because the ribbon connector is just here. So start from this corner here and insert your knife. This is going to come off easier because I've done it before, but just insert your knife and just keep working it in and working it around and just slide it around and keep coming round, and eventually it will come unstuck. If you're replacing it, it doesn't matter if you break it or not. And now we've got this ribbon cable clip to come off, So using your tweezers, just lift that up and away. And now we can unplug the ribbon cable. So just carefully lift that plug up, and that's your LCD screen removed. To save getting fingerprints on it, I'm just going to put a plastic cover on there. Okay, so now we've got six screws to undo to remove the rest of it. So we've got three T5 screws at the bottom here, and these are quite a bit longer than the others, so you can't get them mixed up. That's those three. And before we go any further, we need to put a bit of sticky tape on the camera and the volume buttons. So I'm going to put a bit of sticky tape on the volume button and on the camera button. That stops them falling out when we take it apart. Also, then we need to remove the SIM card and the memory card holders. And now we come up to the top three screws. So you need your Phillips screwdriver for that. And these are the only three Phillips screws on the body, so you can't get them mixed up. As these are near the camera, we call these the camera screws. So to remove the bottom, there's a small clip that's holding it in. So get your screwdriver and just lift that little plastic clip up, and you'll find the bottom comes off nice and easy. And the bottom contains the 3G and the GSM antenna. So if that's damaged, that would affect your reception. Now we can remove the back cover. So turn it over, and then carefully lift the metal case away from the mainboard. So we can remove the shield and the battery. And at the top here we've got a ribbon connector. So you can just pop that open. And then we can lift the mainboard away. This is your SIM card connector. This is a socket for your mini micro SD card. There's a little gasket that goes over the micro USB port that's on there. Now the camera can be changed, but you need a Nokia tool to push the clips in so the camera releases, as plastic is a little bit too thick. Then we come to the speaker housing. You've got the stereo speakers at the bottom here. They come out quite easily. It's just double-sided sticky tape again. And you can't get them in the wrong way because the little plastic tabs are different each side. So that's your stereo speakers. If you need to replace the home button, which is here, it comes as a complete ribbon that goes along and just sticks down on to the board there, and that is also your camera button as well, so that will just come unstuck if you get a new one. Then we've got the volume keys, again that will just come unstuck and you can stick a new one on. Then we've got the earpiece speaker. It's slightly different from the others, but that comes out quite easily, and again you can't get it the wrong way in because plastic tabs. Okay, so the metal case, if you're changing that, you'd need to transfer the headphone socket over. That comes out nice and easy. There's a small rubber gasket that goes around the top, I'll show you where that goes when I put it back together. So reassembly, take your speaker housing and offer up the main board and just insert it so the ribbon cable goes on top like that. And there's some small metal pins, there's one just there and there's one just there, and it locates the circuit for you. Once you've done that, push that ribbon cable back in again. Can be a bit fiddly, this one. There you go, that's fully home now. And insert the battery and the shield over your chips. Then take the metal cover and offer that up, lining the camera up. And the camera's lined up. Push it together and turn it over. And now we can put the three Phillips screws back in the top. Finger tight. So now we come to the bottom. So take one of your long T5 screws and put it in this hole here. Just finger tight, don't go too mad. And then take the antenna and place it on the bottom and try and get that small plastic clip to locate in the bottom there. And then move it around until it sits nicely and you can see it's nice and flush. So you can see it's sitting nice and flush there. When you're happy with that, we put the bottom two screws in. So that's these longer T5 screws. Just finger tight. Looking nice. Then we put the LCD screen back in. So offer up the small plug and just push that into place. You can use your finger or a screwdriver. So it feels like it's gone into place. And then we've got to put the little clip that holds it in. So take that with your tweezers. Hold it and put that end in first and then just push that down until it clicks into place. So it should look nice and flat. So bring that over and give it a gentle push to make sure it's stuck down. Don't push too hard. Once you're happy with that, I'll take off the protective plastic and we'll put the LCD screen back on. So start by bringing the ribbon cable in from the top into that slot there, and then come down to the bottom and offer these little clips up. You can see they're nicely clipped in. And just push the screen down into place and come around to the back, and we can plug that little ribbon cable in. So line it up as best you can and just gently push it into place, don't force it. If it won't go in, you need to move it around a little bit. There you go, it's lined up now and it's snapped into place. Now we can put these two screws back in. One of the silver ones. Just finger tight. And now we've got these silver pins. So you place a silver pin in the hole just there and squeeze the screen against the case, and the silver pin will push in all the way. So just a little bit sticking out. And the same with this side. Take a silver pin, put it in the hole just there, and slide it all the way in, just squeezing the screen together. This side can be a bit difficult. Got to keep moving the pin around. That's gone in now. Just push it all the way home. And so there's a little bit left sticking out. Now we can put the top cover back on. Before we do that, that small rubber gasket that fell off earlier goes onto the headphone socket, and you put it on so the small little tab is just on this little side here. I'll replace the top cover, try and make it nice and flush all the way around, and put the last two silver screws in the top. Just finger tight. There you go. And then we put those double-sided sticky tape covers back on again. Just give it a nice hard push to make sure it sticks into place. If it comes off, you can always replace the double-sided sticky tape. And again, just put that in, give it a nice hard push. So that's the top back together. Then we come to the bottom. Got the final two screws, which are the black ones. And put that plastic cover back on. Give it a nice hard push. Make sure it's stuck down. It's not going to come off. We can remove the sticky tape for the volume and the camera buttons. Reinsert your SIM card. Your memory card, and you probably find it won't switch on when you had it apart. If it won't switch on, just plug it into your USB port and then you'll find it'll switch on after you've done that. But this is switched on okay. Thanks for watching. Please give me the thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll do my best to make some more in the future.